The seminar will be presented in units, which are designed to help you facilitate the information you will learn long after you've completed this course. Seminar objectives. Why have an alcohol server education program and who needs it? Alcohol abuse and the effect it has on society. The liability that you as a server can be accountable for. Restrictions for minor employees. Restrictions for minor guests. Oregon State basic retail liquor laws. The consequences of violating a liquor law. What is alcohol and the physical impact on the body? How to recognize a VIP, which is a visibly intoxicated person. Identifying VIPs and intervention techniques for dealing with them. Legal duties, duties the law requires you to perform. Professional duties, the duties that you choose to perform that go above and beyond legal duties. House duties, house policies are developed by an establishment to help its staff maintain public safety and always have fun while working. Hi, my name's Len Riggs and I'll be the host of this seminar for you today. A little bit about my background. I have been in the restaurant slash hospitality business for what seems like forever in one vein or another. In fact, I wrote this program from the eyes of what you as a server or a bartender or an owner as a manager goes through.
Hey, you two, how are you tonight?
Hey, how's it going?
I'm doing well, thank you. Got some ID?
Yeah.
The fact that it's a very tough business and the fact that alcohol is a big part of our business. Unit 1. The topic is, why have an alcohol server education program and who needs it? Information to be covered in this unit is, number one, who is the OLCC? Number two, who is required to have an ASC permit? Number three, ASC was the hospitality industry's idea. Number four, the purpose of an alcohol server education. Number five, the time frame to get an ASC permit. Number six, not all who apply are eligible to receive an alcohol server education permit. Legal duties, professional duties, and house duties. The Oregon Liquor Control Commission is the state agency that regulates the manufacture, sale, and use of alcoholic beverages. The OLCC is charged with enforcing liquor laws, as well as providing the education that licensees and service permittees need to ensure that Oregon liquor laws are obeyed. Oregon's mandatory alcohol server education is in response to the fact that alcohol is the nation's number one drug problem. By instilling a responsible alcohol server program for those who serve alcohol, we will be able to support the OLCC's commitment to reduce public safety hazards by reducing the number of intoxicated drivers and reducing the incidences of underage drinking. Oregon's mandatory server education derives from the hospitality industry itself. In 1985, the hospitality industry sponsored legislation which established mandatory server education for owners and employees of licensed businesses that serve alcohol by the drink. Anyone who mixes, sells, or serves alcohol in any manner for drinking on the premises and anyone who manages these people must have a service permit. Additionally, anyone who fills growlers for off-premises consumption must also have a service permit. Managers must obtain a permit even if they themselves do not mix, sell, or serve. Cashiers and hosts and hostesses must also obtain a permit even if ringing up the sale of alcohol is their only alcohol service duty. Hosts and hostesses who only greet and seat customers do not need a service permit, but without a service permit, they may not collect money for alcohol, ring up alcohol sales, or help servers deliver or pour alcohol. Persons who perform these duties at a licensed establishment must obtain a service permit even if they are volunteers. Servers at some special events holding a temporary sales license are not required to obtain a service permit. See OAR 845-005-0440 for details. By attending this seminar, you agree to not to consume alcohol or to be under the influence of alcohol or any other intoxicants. To satisfy the seminar's requirements, you must attend and be present for the duration of the seminar. At the conclusion of the seminar, an exam will be given. To pass the exam, a score of 70% must be achieved. You may not refer to any of your notes or discuss any information with others. To receive a server permit, you must first fill out the service permit application available to you from your employer or from the OLCC. Number two, you must be a minimum of 18 years of age to hold a service permit. Number three, the service permit application has to be signed by an authorized person. Authorized persons are owners or managers of licensed establishments, commission-authorized temporary employment agencies, ASC providers, and OLCC staff can endorse service permit application whether or not the student has completed an ASC course. The applicant has 45 days to take an ASC course. To do this, you will need proof of attending an ASC seminar and proof that a passing grade was acquired. Number four,
Have the authorized person mail the completed form and fee to the OLCC. The application is to be transmitted by the end of your first workday following the end of your shift. Number 5, keep a signed copy as your temporary permit. Number 6, you must attend an ASC class within 45 days of submitting your application. Number 7, if you pass a class before you complete a service permit application, the OLCC will give you credit for your class if you apply for a service permit within 2 years of the date you pass the exam, although the service permit will be then valid for 3 years, not 5 years. Number 8, you should receive your permit about 14 days after the OLCC receives your completed service application, the $23 fee, and you have passed the server education test. Number 9, lost, stolen, or destroyed permits, or if your name changes, you are required to apply for a replacement permit immediately. The process is the same as applying for a new permit, and the fee is $5. Number 10, it is illegal for anyone to serve or sell alcohol at an on-premise licensed location without an ASC permit, either by failure to attend a seminar or by having their permit denied, revoked, or suspended. Remember, not all who apply for an ASC permit are approved. If the applicant has felony convictions for drug crimes, crimes of violence or driving while suspended or revoked, convictions or diversions for driving under the influence of intoxicants, a DUII, or had a liquor license or permit canceled for liquor law violations, their ASC permit may not be approved. However, you may provide good cause to overcome your history if you were alcohol or drug addicted at the time of the incidents, or you were diagnosed as alcohol or drug addicted as a result of the incidents. You would be required to provide a sworn statement and additional proof that you have not used drugs or consumed alcohol for 12 months.